Important record now.
It's definitely rough-toothed now. It's the first record ever.
My name is Dima and I joined cetacean research expedition as a drone pilot. Before there was abundance of whales and dolphins in these waters, but a few years ago something changed and now it's almost impossible to find them. So we're back here to understand what is happening and how can we protect them. If you wonder how we can find cetaceans in this sea, well, that's because we have this huge 200 meter long hydrophone. We put it underwater and drag behind us pretty much all the time. With it, we can hear everything in a radius of 20 kilometers.
When we started this study in 2018, we had more bottlenose dolphins, we had more common dolphins, we had more striped dolphins. Now, there's not that much. They all have a sign of starvation. For common dolphin, I think it's the worst. We don't see them anymore. It's the last sighting is 2020. And since 2020, 4 years passed. And including this survey, we have nothing. For sperm whales, they have ship strikes. We can see them on their fin or on their body as well. The good news is they have calves, they have juveniles in the group. But still, we cannot really figure out how many out there because we need more effort.
I heard click sound of the sperm whale like 3 times at least.
The click doesn't look that close.
So we just heard some clicks of the sperm whales and the conditions are perfect right now. It's really almost no wind, no waves, but the clicks a bit disappeared and we're like looking in all directions right now. Possibly there are 2 sperm whales, but we really don't see them.
I don't know where they are.
I think there are 2 of them.
Yeah, I mean, it's getting one bit front, one behind, and I think they're probably on the surface somewhere.
So we decided to use another hydrophone, which can give us more precise direction.
They're making a few clicks at the moment.
Okay. Yeah, pick a direction and go on it. But why can't we find it? Yeah.
Much of the marine life populations of cetaceans in the Eastern Mediterranean are endangered. So the numbers we find in the Eastern Mediterranean, such as sperm whales, are quite low, and may go extinct in our lifetime if we're not more protective and more careful.
If we hear animals, we can try to find it because I think this is not that bad.
Our plan was to sail all night, so in the morning we will be in the place where we have the most chances of seeing sperm whales. And also, we will be monitoring underwater sounds to see if there are any animals on our way. But something unexpected happened.
Oh, yeah, can you hear us?
Yeah.
They are clicking and whistling.
Dolphins.
It's crazy.
Dolphins, yeah.
A lot of them, yeah.
Oh, it buzzed.
I'm 90% sure of stroke.
There's lots of bells and creaks and
stuff like that. It's more common with the bottom bells actually, so.
Yes, because it's such a low
frequency.
Peak frequency.
Very low.
With bottom bells, I generally get 4 to 50 kilos. This is like all below 30.
The rest of the night we spent wondering what kind of dolphins we heard, because the sound we got was very unusual and quite different from any species present in the area.
As soon as the sun rises up, guys on the deck to look out for the whales. It was a bit rough night, a bit wavy, but yeah, here we are.
Habitat destruction is the main problem. And we should say no for any kind of plastic as well, because we have multiple cases that the animal actually stranded and died just because of this plastic pollution. And marine traffic as well.
We have to change 180.
180?
Yeah. You got dolphins?
Yes.
So they could have been very close to the hydrophone and then just gone back further. We're looking
there. There. Yeah, we've seen them.
We've seen them.
Here.
So that's right beside you.
Right on the bow.
30 degrees.
30. Okay, I'm launching a drone.
Call point updated.
But behavior of these dolphins was quite unusual. They were very passive and always formed a small groups. That's when we start to wonder what kind of dolphins we see.
The slope of the head, I just looked back over one of the pictures, it's perfectly rough-toothed.
No?
Could it be interspecies breeding? But rough-toothed should have quite
a bit. Right under. Ah, it's so cool.
It's rough-toothed.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm 100% sure.
Patrick, no.
You're not sure.
No, I never be sure before I see 100% proof.
Oh my God, it's a baby. Yes, the rough-toothed. Dima, this is a baby important record now.
It's definitely rough-toothed now. Oh my God. This is a better funding than sperm whales.
Is it the first time you see them?
First time. It's not only me, actually. It's the first record ever from this region.
So right now was quite important and epic moment. We spotted first time ever rough-toothed dolphins. No one ever seen them here in Turkey, in the Eastern Mediterranean. And we not only seen them, we've got a lot of acoustics, drone shots, a lot of pictures and videos and a lot of data. And it's incredible. It's like, I don't know, scientific discovery in a way. And it feels so amazing, everyone's so excited because it's a new thing, and that's why, you know, people go to such researches, that's why they organize expedition to discover something new, and we did, and it's like, it feels so good.
This is amazing, seriously. I'm so surprised, because at the end, whatever we count is important, because we will report this to the scientific committee and also to the decision makers to take conservation step.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Yes, finally. Oh, I'm on the land. Just this one day was worth me coming all the way from Latvia here. And I'm super happy about it because sometimes you feel you do something and it's, you know, not much of a value, maybe you shouldn't come, it's not that important, but these days like this, it really proves otherwise. And the guy's gonna make a scientific paper, and it's a big thing, it's a really big thing.
So I was so happy that we had the chance to bring one more species to Turkey's cetacean species list. The species has never been recorded from the Turkish territorial waters. We were always thinking they're here, but we were only lacking this proof. So now we have the proof. And the group was actually quite healthy. They were like chubby, you know? You don't see the ribs, you don't see the blowhole thing. So these are all good signs that they have kind of a stable population over here. And comparing to striped dolphins or bottlenose dolphins we had encountered in this survey, they look more healthier than the rest of the species. Each of us is responsible to protect these animals and to protect the wildlife overall. It's easy to blame something, it's harder to look inside. So I think the biggest solution is us. So we need to make sure that we change our attitude, we raise our voice, we need to be more sustainable on our actions, we need to be more wise on our decision, and we need to consume less. This way there will be less production as well.
This is the video from last year expedition, where you can find way more information about daily life on boat, how do we track whales, how do we record them, and so forth. If you like my videos, subscribe to my channel. You can also support me on the Patreon. Thank you for watching, and be brave to act.